I'm going to talk about LightSail, which is probably not the most sexy product that Amazon's had to release in the last 3 months. They're basically images built by Bitmami, which has been around for a while, even pre-Amazon, and can be deployed on a whole bunch of things. So these are the application stacks you can deploy in around about 5 minutes, and it actually works as per advertised, and you can get it for $5. So for $5 per month, you can get any one of these application stacks up and running in around about 5 minutes. You literally need, I think, one entry point field for the name of the thing you want to build, and then a box count for how many of them you want, and it's done. The rest is all automated. It doesn't expose any other of the Amazon ecosystem to create these things, so you don't need to know about elastic load balancers, networking, VPCs, or any of that stuff. It just deploys a box and dumps it on the internet, gives you shell access. That's it. It kind of has some overlap with some other Amazon services. And I've been asked by a few people, you know, that are they disrupting their own ecosystem? And they're not really. So there's sort of four product spaces that cover the sort of technologies that can be used. In this example, I'm essentially demonstrating how you could deploy an Express application, so Node Express. You could put it into LightSail, which is going to be very, very simple. 5 minutes, you're going to have a $5 box and be able to deploy your Node app. EC2 instances can do exactly the same thing, but EC2 is essentially a building block. It's like Lego. It's one part, and you're going to have to assemble many different parts to try and get Amazon to deploy a resilient or highly available solution in their ecosystem. So LightSail is basically the lowest possible entry point to build a server. It is the absolute minimum piece of complexity you need to give somebody a box on the internet. So the existing market today is these people. These are the four probably biggest VPS providers that you will find. There are literally thousands upon thousands of companies that do VPS. It's around about a $15 billion industry globally. It employs a great many people and runs half of the internet's cap pages. LightSail has thrown itself directly in that market. Now, Amazon basically gets access to this market for free. It's not having to create anything novel. It's using its existing infrastructure. It's just hiding it all under a single page form to buy it. So you get access to what is essentially an EC2 box, an elastic load balancer, a VPC, subnets, security groups, and all of the other capabilities that Amazon has. They just slap a new brand on it and they sell it to you for $5. They get to slice and dice their infrastructure even thinner than they ever have before, so their margins are staggering, and you get a $5 server. And they actually perform pretty well, considering that, you know, they've got about 512 mega RAM, but if you're trying to run, you know, a Joomla box or a GitLab box or something like that, you've got a few users, it's really not going to get hit very hard. Amazon has some disadvantages right now over its competitors in this space in the fact that they have zero support. One of the big advantages that LightSail does have as a hosting component that none of their competitors are going to be able to deliver is this lot. So yes, it only costs you $5, and yes, it's dead easy to set up, but if 6 months later you realize that actually what you wanted was a lot more complex, and you actually want to use DynamoDB, you have access to every other Amazon service. The ones that survive, that's their market that they can then start pitching additional services to. So out of that $15 billion industry, they're going to try and capture all the people who actually want to do something interesting. Industry impacts, VPS industry, it has very little value add. If you look at most of the IT industry, even what Amazon does, what Amazon intrinsically does is remove value from the ecosystem. So at the end of the day, when we all used to run physical tin, we used to be able to, as a service provider or as an IT company, we would add value on top, and we could manage our underlying infrastructure costs and shuffle the deck a bit to try and capture that value, and that's what we call profit. Amazon strips that right back. So they take all the profit and they leave next to nothing behind.